Hi viewers, it's me Kartini again, and today we are going to see how to prepare lunch according to the Suku Suku Separuh of Pinggan Sehat Malaysia. So for our half, I'm sorry, for our quarter or Suku of Pinggan Sehat Malaysia, we have yellow capsicum rice with dill. So the ingredients will be rice, dill, yellow capsicum and onions. For our half or fruits and vegetables, we'll be having masala grilled eggplant and mushroom. So we have here eggplant, king oyster mushrooms, curry leaves, curry powder. We also have a salsa for the vegetables too, which is green apple and orange salsa. For our quarter protein or suku of the Pinggan Sehat Malaysia, we have cheese and alfalfa omelette. We have egg, grated cheese and alfalfa. So let's see how we are going to cook these three recipes today. So the first dish we are going to do is cheese omelette with alfalfa. What we have to do is we'll add a little bit of oil to the pan. This is olive oil. And just swirl the pan around so you get the oil evenly on all sides of your pan and your omelette won't stick later on. Once you have swirled it, I have here egg that has already been beaten. So pour it in and give your pan a swirl. So egg has a lot of protein and it's one of the best forms of proteins that a non-vegetarian can have. It's a powerhouse in a small package of protein. So once you have added in the egg, when it's still moist like this, you should add in your cheese so that your cheese will stick. So you have grated cheese here. For this omelette, you don't have to add salt because you already have the cheese here. So you'll reserve a little later for sprinkling on top. Then we also have our alfalfa here. So what you do is you just spread your alfalfa out. Alfalfa, although it's just a sprout, it contains a lot of essential minerals and vitamins such as vitamin A, E and K as well. So now after putting in our alfalfa, we'll just give it a pat so that it settles into your egg. And we'll let it set for about a minute before you flip it over. So our egg is already done, as you can see it's already set. So once it's set, you just have to flip it over. So our suku, a quarter of our protein for Pinggan Sehat Malaysia is ready. This is our cheese and alfalfa omelette. So we reserved a little bit of cheese just now. Just add it on top while it's still hot so it'll be melted and oozing. There you go. So you don't need any salt as I have mentioned earlier because the cheese is already salty. So there you have it. Egg and alfalfa and cheese omelette ready. For our second recipe, we'll be doing yellow capsicum rice with dill. So first, as usual, we'll start off with a little bit of olive oil, which is about 3 teaspoons. Then we'll add in some white onions. First, then only we'll add in the capsicum a little later. Okay, so now we'll saute the onions for a while until it's a little bit translucent. Once they are a bit translucent, you'll add in your capsicum. Here we're using yellow capsicum. As you can see, it's really bright yellow. A bright orange or a bright yellow usually indicates that this food has a lot of vitamin C content, which is good for your skin, which is good. So once this is half cooked, we'll add a little bit of salt, which will help with the caramelizing process along the way. So there's some salt inside. Once you add some salt, you can add a little bit of white pepper, just a pinch. and then give it a stir so that the salt and the pepper is well combined. Okay, once you have done that, you will add in the dill, because aromatics have to go in earlier to infuse throughout the dish. So we'll add in some finely chopped dill. Dill has a lot of health benefits from its smell. Even though it's just a herb, it contains magnesium, iron, as well as copper, which is good for the body. So as you can see, we'll cook this down a little until it's like a paste. After that, we'll add in the rice to coat it. As you can see, our onions and capsicum have fully cooked and the smell of dill is already being emitted. We'll add in our rice. Once you add in your rice, just give it a quick stir. This is a very good recipe for those who are bored of eating just plain white rice, or like if you are not a fan of raw vegetables, you can just add it into a rice like this. It's a totally different menu and all the health benefits are there. Alright, so the rice has been stirred. One last stir so that everything is properly and we can plate it already. So now we are about to plate our suku, or quarter of carbohydrates for the pinggan saya Malaysia, which is our yellow capsicum rice with dill. I can almost smell the wonderful aroma of dill. It makes me hungry just smelling it. Okay, so there you have it. Yellow capsicum rice with dill is ready. So we'll look at our next recipe. So for our third and final recipe, we'll be doing masala grilled aubergine or eggplant with mushrooms. So first of all, I've already well greased my pan. It's olive oil, so you don't have to worry about anything. Next, we'll add in our eggplant. And also our mushrooms. So eggplant has a lot of dietary fiber, which is good for healthy bowel movement. Mushrooms on the other hand have blood thinning properties that will enable good blood circulation in the body. So when taken in combination, it actually increases overall gut health as well as a better digestive system. So now, while our eggplant and our mushrooms are cooking, we'll be doing our green apple and orange salsa. So for the salsa, it's very simple. Our acid comes from our orange, so you don't need to add any lime juice. Just add a little bit of salt and a little bit of white pepper. So vitamin C in oranges is very good for health, like how we saw the capsicum just now. Then we also have green apples, which are high in dietary fiber as well as vitamin A. So now all you have to do is just give it a stir so that the salt, pepper is incorporated with the green apple and the orange. So once you have given it a stir, all you have to do is place it on your plate and your salsa is ready. So now let's go back to our aubergine and mushroom. At this point, you can see that our aubergine and our mushrooms have browned a little, but it's still not cooked yet. At this stage, to add aroma and flavor, we add in some fresh curry leaves, which I've already torn here. Oh, that smell of curry. Yeah, because it's masala grilled, right? Okay. So now we have added in the curry leaves. So what happens is that the flavor of the curry leaves will be infused. Now we can add some salt to help the caramelization process along. Just a pinch. And give it a quick stir. So now we have added the curry leaves in. We are also going to add a little bit of curry powder here. You can use any curry powder of your choice, a spicy one. If you are not into spicy, just add a little bit of a milder curry powder. So we are adding in a little bit. Now we'll give it a quick stir. So now we are ready to plate our masala grilled eggplant and mushrooms. This is really meaty, like a spicy kind of vegetarian steak. So if you are craving for meat and you don't have it at home, you can just get some aubergines and mushrooms and cook it up this way. Okay, and we have our mushrooms on one side. So now our lunch is ready, and we have applied the Suku Suku's Paru Pinggan Sehat Malaysia here. Our first quarter is cheese omelette with alfalfa, which is a quarter of protein. Then for our quarter of carbohydrates, we have yellow capsicum rice with dill. Then for our most important part, fruits and veggies, we have green apple and orange salsa, and masala grill, aubergine and mushrooms. To eat is a necessity, but to eat intelligently, it's an art. So come on, let's enjoy our lunch. Would you like to join me? I'm about to have mine. Okay, let's try a little bit of our yellow capsicum rice. That's a really good rice. You have the sweetness from your capsicums there. Dill is really aromatic. I have to say, I really did a good job there. Next, we'll try a little bit of omelette. Ooh la la. It's cheesy and so, so good. Trust me, if you make this omelette, you're gonna make it every day of your life. Next, we'll try the orange and green apple salsa. So, this salsa can be replaced with green apple for those who don't like the sourness or extra piquancy that comes from green apples. So, let's give it a bite. Salsa without all the fuss, that's seriously good. Trust me. Next, we'll move on to our masala grill, aubergines and mushroom. This is so good. I love my mushroom. It's really good and I love spicy food. You should try it out. Next is our aubergine. Does it taste like steak or is it just me? Oh well, I'll catch you in the next episode with more simple recipes for lunch. Bye!